Hello, Townsend Harris, and welcome to the final episode of New Hawk One. I'm Renania.
And I'm Udipto.
This week's episode will focus on the economy, jobs, and housing.
Earlier this week, one of our field crews ambushed the candidates for City Council District 30, Robert Holden and Liz Crowley.
Let's take a look.
Hello, this is Hawk Attack, and we're going to ambush Liz Crowley and Robert Holden in their Participate Democracy class. Ready? Let's go.
It has to be 9 minutes. That's my only class.
Holden. Hey, I have a few questions for you. You ready?
Can we do this somewhere else?
What do you think about the current job market and how you plan to create more jobs to fix it?
So the current job market is improving, but is still suffering. I feel that the jobs in our district should increase because a lot of people are left homeless. And so we want a new community board so that the homeless would have an opportunity to get job referrals. And that way the job market would increase. We're also focusing on a number of new development for new buildings. And that way a lot more jobs are going to be opened up with the new construction in place.
Will this also try to help combat the homelessness problem in New York City?
Yes, so along with in our district there are a lot of new buildings coming up, and so there are a lot of floors that could be dedicated to the homeless. So we want to make sure that at least 2 floors in every new building being built is dedicated to the homeless. Along with that, we want to make sure that 15% of new zoning districts are dedicated to affordable housing for families with lower incomes.
All right, thank you for your time. We're going to go for Liz Crowley now. Okay, this is Hawk Attack. We're going to try to get Liz Crowley now. Hey, Liz Crowley, I have a few questions for you, okay?
The current job market consists of unions and the federal government's Social Security pension system. So I think that right now the current job market needs improvement in those two areas, because I do feel like retirement plans and 401ks do need a little bit of work. So to create more jobs, I want to increase the taxes on the top 1%, and this will let us create more jobs in our public system, such as transportation and schools.
How do you plan to combat the rate of homelessness in New York City?
Okay, well, currently I am for making more shelters in our community, but I do want to make them not close to our communities to keep our communities in order and safe. You can't just place more shelters anywhere that you want to. You have to think strategically and make sure that the people are safe while doing so.
Okay, thank you for your time.
Hello, this is Derek Moore with Hawk Attack, and we are going to ambush J.C. Polanco and ask him a few questions.
Oh, J.C. Polanco, we have a few questions for you. What is the rate of homelessness in New York City?
What? Hold on a second. First off, I do know that the rate of mental health homeless people is 15% of the total homeless population. So I do know the percentage of what I'm trying to focus on.
What is the state of the job market in New York City?
People have rights when they go into an interview. The interviewer cannot ask a person certain things that take away their liberties, such as religion, how they feel about certain political ideas. So I think we need to make sure that job interviewers are not infringing on people's rights.
We're going to ambush Letitia James and ask a few questions about housing and jobs. I have a few questions for you. You ready? I'll take that as a yes. That's a great answer. That's the one I wanted to hear. Now, what is the rate of homelessness in New York City?
Can I put my shoes down?
Sure.
My microphone is up here.
What was your question?
What is the rate of homelessness in New York City and how you plan to fix it?
I believe the rate of homelessness in New York City is 20%. How I plan to fix it is definitely building more homeless shelters, but on top of building more homeless shelters, we have to make sure that we take steps to prepare the people who are on the streets to start bettering their lives. So we could work with them to get them a higher education if they need. And if they don't need a higher education and their problem was just like previous life choices, that we can get them back on the right track to getting them better jobs to better support themselves.
Okay, that's cool. And lastly, what do you think about the current job market and how do you plan to create more jobs for New York City's people?
So a big problem with the current job market is actually like discrimination towards different types of people, not only just racial discrimination, but also gender discrimination and sexuality discrimination. So I think we can enforce more policies to make sure that businesses don't really have the opportunity to discriminate. So one thing that I've done is that I've put in a policy so that they can't request previous salary information. So that also helps people get more jobs because they basically can't hire you based off of your previous salary. Because what a lot of businesses were doing was they were looking at your previous salary, and if they hired you, they basically make sure to give you either just a little bit over that to help you think that it's a better job, or they give you a little under that. That way they know that, oh, we have this leeway because they're only making this much beforehand.
All right, that's great to hear. Thank you for your time.
Now here are some interviews with your fellow Harrisites.
You're going to ambush some underclassmen now. Hello.
No.
Who is your favorite candidate right now and who you will definitely be voting for?
Jimmy McMillan, because he has a funny catchphrase.
Cool. And what was your favorite TV segment?
Hawk Attack.
Awesome. I like that answer. All right, cool. What is your favorite ad?
Scott Stringer.
And lastly, who will you definitely be voting for?
I like Mally Otakis. She was nice.
How did TV segments this year? Are they good?
TV segments are pretty good.
Which candidate will you definitely be voting for?
Scott Stringer.
What is your favorite ad right now?
Scott Stringer.
Scott Stringer. Yeah, Scott Stringer.
Scott Stringer. Who will you definitely be voting for?
Scott Stringer.
How is election simulation right now?
It's cool, bro. I think it's really fun. And I think it's a good way to represent the election, and I think it's a really smart thing to do, considering that we probably don't know anything about the election to begin with, so.
What is your favorite ad?
Faulkner, when he's like been in the sim bucks, you know, like.
Who will you definitely be voting for this election?
My boy de Blasio, and also, Scott Stringer is a bum.
I'm so tired of this segment.
We asked random people one simple question.
If you were in charge of New York City and you had $27 million, what would you spend it on?
I mean, there's a lot to do with $27 million.
I would try to cure hunger, and that would be my first thing.
Better education.
Just in general, like improving the quality of life.
Improve the education system.
Would you ever consider giving that money to criminals who don't pay taxes?
No. That's stupid.
Then we asked Nicole Malliotakis what she thought.
Well, for once, I wouldn't do what de Blasio does. He's pretty much using that $27 million to protect illegal immigrants and defending them in court who are committing crimes like grand larceny, sex abuse, and patronizing a minor for prostitution. With that $27 million, I would direct it to stuff that we actually need in the city, like helping the homelessness cause, and also directing it towards education.
Nicole Malliotakis supports FAIR. So on election day, say no to de Blasio, go to the polls, and vote for Nicole.
Now here's some footage from the special interest rally.
We represent the NFIB, the National Federation of Independent Businesses.
And what candidates do you guys support?
We're a nonpartisan group, but we're throwing our support behind Nicole Malliotakis.
And what are some issues that you guys advocate for?
So we're for lowering taxes, decreasing overbearing government regulations, and basically supporting anything that will support the creation of small businesses.
I'm the co-chair of the NYCLU.
What candidates does the NYCLU support?
Although we're nonpartisan, we support Scott Stringer, Bill de Blasio, Carlina Rivera, and Elizabeth Crowley.
And what is your main goal by the end of the election?
Really to educate people on civil liberties and make sure that they're voting for the right candidate.
And what interests do you guys represent?
Politics for the homeless.
And what candidates do you guys support?
We support de Blasio, but we're also bipartisan.
Offer different services, like obviously we're going to provide some housing, or if they need food, we have a portable food soup kitchen.
Also give them job training to make sure that their life is set, and make sure that they can have a stable life after the revolt.
Hello, we are here with Olivia, a member of the Humane Society. Olivia, can you tell us some of the recent accomplishments of the Humane Society?
Thank you for having me. Recently, the Humane Society has helped ban the sale of puppy mill dogs in Philadelphia, and we've stopped the Elephant Acts and the Ringling Brothers Circus.
Every day, over 60,000 individuals live on the streets of New York City without food, water, and shelter. They often live with mental illnesses and are forced to endure the cold alone. The homeless level is the highest it's ever been since the Great Depression, and no one is there to help. Struck with economic disaster, ordinary people are constantly losing their jobs and homes with no hope of recovery. These individuals are unable to provide for themselves and instead rely on the generosity of others in order to get by. Many are pressured to perform menial tasks in exchange for pocket change and small meals. Coalition for the Homeless reaches out to those in need of assistance, providing homeless individuals with proper care, housing, food, and clothing. Our programs, shelter monitoring, and grassroots organizing enable us to meet homeless people where they are, giving a voice and help to the most marginalized among us. Homeless, but not hopeless.
This past Wednesday, there was a final debate between all the candidates.
Let's see some of the highlights.
Before we start, I would just like to bring attention to Mr. de Blasio's shoes. I think they're the top three worst pair of shoes I've ever seen in my life.
Well, I would have to say you're in the top three worst public advocates in New York City.
So first of all, Halloween was yesterday, but she's still pretending to be a councilwoman.
There's a reason why you're not running for mayor.
He was once a Democrat running against me in primaries. He lost and he found a loophole to run against me again.
Lil de Blasio, so how did you think the debate went?
I mean, I wish we had more time to get our issues across to the audience. I feel like the time was too limited. I couldn't deliver my message as smoothly as I wanted to.
Hey, Michael Faulkner, what did you think about the debate?
Well, I kind of panicked in the second round, but the first one I think was very successful. Skr, skr.
Philip on the beat, so it's not nice. Yeah, Faulkner, you had a good run. Now your campaign's pretty much done, You guys never had a chance against us. All you guys ever did was complain and fuss, Stringer dominated and ran the game, yeah. All the Faulkner's dance moves were lame, yeah. Copy out at them, what a shame. Don't ever forget Scott Stringer is the name, yeah.
Listen up, you guys.
I'm Miss Levi.
I'm Miss Crowley.
I'm Mr. Heitman.
I'm Mr. Stern.
I'm Dr. Mezza.
I'm Mom the Cat.
I'm Mr. V.
And I feel total solidarity with
Black Lives Matter.
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 Between the candidates for City Council District 2.
Today I'm here with Jimmy McMillan and Carlina Rivera for the two candidates running for City Council District 2. So, Carlina, because Rosie Mendez is the current City Council for District 2, and if you are elected as City Council for District 2, how are you going to improve or continue Rosie Mendez's term?
That's a great question. I actually worked under Rosie Mendez, and I fully support all of the efforts and everything that she's completed so far. And in terms of economics, I'm going to push for small businesses. One of the things that I personally did that she supports is the Small Business Job Survival Act, which helps put power back in the hands of small businesses. And in order to boost the economy, I'm going to help create internship programs and apprenticeship programs that allow people to get jobs.
What about you?
How could you trust Carlina Rivera with this when the last person did absolutely nothing for District 2? It's already been many years and we've seen no changes whatsoever.
But do you know anything about the last person?
That's why, as a Republican, I plan to bring change. We're gonna lower the taxes in the area so I can actually and seriously start bringing in small businesses to our neighborhood. Carlina Rivera is a Democrat. She's going to raise the taxes. What kind of business would try to open their company in District 2.
I don't believe you know what the Small Business Job Survival Act actually does. All right.
Carlina, how would you combat the high cost of living in District 2?
That's a great question. So along with new housing, which helps create homes for these people, there's a thing called tenant protection. So when these people enter their lease agreements, it will give them a fixed rent. So say the landlord and the people agreed on $500 a month for rent because they cannot afford more money than that. That's the price that they'll have to pay until they're out of their lease or until they decide to move out. And along with that, the right to counsel exists, which basically means if the landlord feels like they can push up the rent or hike up the rent, these people have a lawyer that will help them to get the proper rights that they deserve.
This is all talk. This is all talk. This is what all Democrats do. They all think they can change everything. That's not how it works. This is what I'm going to do. This is what I'm going to do. The rent is too damn high in New York City. I'm going to drop the taxes on property. Then everyone's rent is going down. And in my district too, I will make sure that there's no gentrification that's hitting our district. Additionally, for homeless people, after we lower the rent, many of them can leave the shelters, can leave off the streets, and find a roof over their head.
You're all talk too, McMillan.
Any last remarks?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
As we all know, the rent is too damn high. It's been too damn high for the last 10 years. The taxes in New York City are killing us. Vote Republican and we can make a change. These Democrats, they all talk for the last decades. We have to do something now.
I'm going to keep it short and simple. All McMillan has been doing this whole campaign is talk. Talks about how the rent is too damn high, has nothing else to say. I clearly have said things and I want you guys to listen to me when I tell you change will come if you vote Democrat on election day.
Thanks for watching, and now the 2017 New Hawk One crew.
That's all for this year, Towson Harris.
Tune into our live stream this Monday.
Zipto out.
Renee out.
And cut.
With a population of 8.5 million people.
In order to fix these social issues. Social issues. Nick. Social issues that you plan on.
Why is my
Philadelphia and so big. You're like, and
come on.
Matt Stringer and Republican Michael J. Faulkner. It's nice to have you on the show.
Thank you. It's a pleasure to be here.
Cut!
It's an inch.
Cut!
Okay, no. It's a pleasure to be here.
Okay,
same here. Thank you. It's a pleasure to be here. Yeah.
Cut!
Rolling!
And. Ah, oh, sorry, Josh.
Hey, one!
Is that someone sleeping? Is that a candidate? Yes. Oh, okay, not a candidate.
Between the two candidates for city council district, raise the standards for homelessness or those who don't live in houses.
What the hell? No, you have to repeat.
It's been too damn high for the mother.
Yes. Where'd you get this from?
Healthcare.
So from these are the actual
yes.
Wait, so this is bullshit.